This is my painting of a pair of swans. I hope you will agree, having watched the following, are definitely soulmates. I'd like to share with you the circumstances in which it was painted, how it inspired me, and how I finally managed to capture them on canvas. Whenever we can, Eileen and I take to our road bikes, and one of our favourite stopping points is a lock not 15 minutes ride from our home. It's peaceful and beautiful at any time of the year, and we usually make our way along an old jetty where we can sit and watch the multitude of wild birds spread like confetti across the waters that surround us. In 2010, however, we were given an extra bonus as a pair of swans had built their nest close by. So close, in fact, that they were almost in the mouth of a boathouse which flanks the old jetty. This did not seem to bother them, and they were very trusting of our presence, and we began to visit them regularly in order that we could watch them at work and going about their routines. So comfortable were they that they would be quite happy to groom themselves as we sat within feet of them. It was both mesmerizing and relaxing to watch the movements of their necks as they worked fastidiously on keeping their feathers whiter than white. No rest for the male, therefore. He is busy gardening. His garden consists of fine reeds, which he is clearing away so that his youngsters will have a clear area in which they will be safe, whilst also providing fresh building material to add to the nest. Over the weeks that followed, the nest was continually changing colour as he added more fresh greens to the already substantial mound. Then one morning we arrived to discover that the eggs we had glimpsed several weeks earlier had become three chirpy cygnets. That was when I knew I simply had to capture this charming scene in one of my miniature oil paintings. A female swan and her brood were essential, but I also wanted to capture the male. After all, he was the protector of this new family, took his responsibility seriously, and was obviously very proud of his role. Even with her three cygnets, the female did not seem to mind our presence, and she allowed us to see them several times before drawing the youngsters back once more into the fold and warmth of her wing. It was a demanding composition to assemble, because I wanted to include so many elements in what is, after all, a miniature. I also wanted to recreate the light of the lock, the warmth of the sun on white feathers and green leaf against the dark coolness of the water. The following start-to-finish reveal will give you some idea of how I managed to balance all the elements.